गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज़ वेनसडे, दैट इज 3rd February 2021। थॉट ऑफ द वीक, थिंग्स वर्क आउट बेस्ट फॉर दोज हु मेक द बेस्ट ऑफ हाउ थिंग्स वर्क आउट, जॉन वुडन। आई रिपीट, थिंग्स वर्क आउट बेस्ट फॉर दोज हु मेक द बेस्ट ऑफ हाउ थिंग्स वर्क आउट, जॉन वुडन। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 11. We have seen what is proportion, then we have seen what is ratio. Examples related to proportion in daily life, and we have seen some important points regarding ratio. We have done some solved examples also, and we have already started practice set 28. We have done question number 1 and question number 2. Let's begin with the third question. Rima has 24 notebooks and 18 books. Find the ratio of notebooks to books. Solution: ratio is equal to notebooks upon books is equal to 24 notebooks upon 18 books. Both these numbers 24 and 18 are divisible by 6. Therefore, 24 divided by 6 upon 18 divided by 6. We get the simplest form as 4 upon 3. Therefore, answer. Therefore, the ratio of the notebooks to the books is 4 upon 3. Question number 4. 30 cricket players and 20 kho-kho players are training on a field. What is the ratio of cricket players to the total number of players? Solution: total number of players is equal to number of cricket players plus number of kho-kho players is equal to 30 plus 20 is equal to 50 players. Therefore, there are 50 players on a field, training on a field. Let's find the ratio. Ratio is equal to number of cricket players upon total number of players. Number of cricket players is 30 and total number of players training on a field is 50. Therefore, 30 upon 50 is the ratio. Now, both these numbers are divisible by 10. Therefore, 30 divided by 10 upon 50 divided by 10. The simplest form we get as 3 upon 5, because 30 divided by 10 gives you 3 and 50 divided by 10 gives you 5. Answer: therefore, the ratio of cricket players to that of total number of players is 3 upon 5. Question number 5, that is the last question of the practice set 28, is question number 5, snail has a red ribbon and that is 80 centimeters long, and a blue ribbon 2.20 meter long. What is the ratio of the length of red ribbon to that of the blue ribbon? I repeat, snail has a red ribbon that is 80 centimeter long and a blue ribbon 2.20 meter long. What is the ratio of the length of red ribbon to that of the blue ribbon? Now students, if you see this example very carefully, the length of red ribbon is given in centimeter, whereas the length of the blue ribbon is given in meter. Therefore, first we have to make the units of both these same. Solution: since 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, therefore 2.20 meter is equal to 2 into 100 centimeter plus 20 centimeter. 2 into 100 gives you 200. Therefore, 200 centimeter plus 20 centimeter, we get 220 centimeter. Now, the length of both red and blue ribbon is in centimeter. Therefore, the ratio is equal to length of red ribbon upon length of blue ribbon is equal to 80 centimeter upon 220 centimeter. Now, centimeter gets cancelled. Therefore, 80 upon 220. Both these numbers are completely divisible by 20. Therefore, 80 divided by 20 upon 220 divided by 20. The final answer we get as 4 upon 11. Answer: therefore, the ratio of the length of red ribbon to that of blue ribbon is 4 upon 11. Last question of practice set 28. That is question number 6. Shubham's age today is 12 years and His father's is 42 years. Shubham's mother is younger than his father by 6 years. Find the following ratios. I repeat, Shubham's age today is 12 years and his father's is 42 years. Means Shubham's present age is 12 years and his father's present age is 42 years. Shubham's mother is younger than his father by 6 years. Means if you want to find out Shubham's mother's present age, then you have to subtract 6 from 42. Find the following ratios. First ratio, ratio of Shubham's age today to his mother's age today. Second one, ratio of Shubham's mother's age today to his father's age today. And third ratio, the ratio of Shubham's age to his mother's age when Shubham was 10 years old. Let's see the solution. Shubham's present age is equal to 12 years. His father's present age is equal to 42 years. Since Shubham's mother is younger than his father by 6 years, therefore Shubham's mother's age, present age, is equal to 42 minus 6 years is equal to 36 years. Therefore, the first ratio, Shubham's present age upon his mother's present age, is equal to 12 years upon 36 years. Years get cancelled and both these numbers 12 and 36 are completely divisible by 12. Therefore, 12 divided by 12 upon 36 divided by 12 is equal to 1 upon 3. Therefore, the ratio of Shubham's present age to his mother's present age is 1 upon 3. Second question. Here we have to find out the ratio of Shubham's mother's present age upon Shubham's father's present age is equal to 36 years upon 42 years. Years gets cancelled. Therefore, 36 upon 42. Both these numbers are completely divisible by 6. Therefore, 36 divided by 6 upon 42 divided by 6 is equal to 6 upon 7. Third ratio, Shubham's mother's age when Shubham was 10 years old. Now today, Shubham is 12 years old and when he was 10 years old, his mother's age, means if you want to find out Shubham's mother's age when he was 10 years old, we have to take out 2 from 36, present age of mother. Therefore, 36 minus 2 is equal to 34 years. Therefore, ratio is equal to Shubham's age before 10 years. Shubham's age when he was 10 years and Shubham's mother's age when he was 10 years old is equal to 10 years upon 34 years is equal to 10 upon 34 because years and year gets cancelled. Both these numbers are divisible by 2. Therefore, 10 divided by 2 upon 34 divided by 2 is equal to 5 upon 17. Therefore, the ratio of Shubham's age to his mother's age when he was 10 years old is 5 upon 17. Now, students, you have to write down all the matter from given slides correctly in your copy. Complete your work on time. See you in the next period. Thank you and have a nice day.